The sister asked the question.
So the question is, is it really, it's a haram to pet a dog, and then can they judge me as not a Muslim just because I love the dogs and pets the dogs?
Sister, what's your background? Are you a Catholic, are you a Christian, or are you Muslim? Or?
No, I believe I'm Islam. But if you say that Muslim is totally...
No, were you born in a Muslim family, sister?
But I don't think they really...
No, were you born in a Muslim family?
Yes.
You were born in a Muslim family and you are a Muslim. But you have got pets as dogs.
Mm-hmm.
Sister, we would prefer that non-Muslim should be given the first chance. But since you have come, I will answer your question. I would request the volunteers that before anyone asks a question, please check whether they are Muslims or non-Muslims. I believe you are born in a Muslim family and you are a Muslim, correct?
I believe I am Muslim, but they say that I am not Muslim.
No, but you believe you are Muslim, correct?
Yes.
But just because you keep dogs as pets and the prophets earlier kept dogs to take care of the sheep, of the cattle, so the other people say you are not a Muslim. Sister, in Islam, keeping dog is prohibited in your house as a pet. But keeping a dog for hunting is no problem. As a guard in your house, no problem. So what the prophets used to keep dogs was to keep the flock of the cattle together, that is permitted. So if you use dog for hunting, it's allowed. To take care of the cattle, it's allowed. To keep a dog to guard your house outside is allowed. But in the house as pet, it is not prohibited. It is prohibited, sister. It is prohibited because the spit of the dog, it's unclean. And today even science tells us that the saliva of the dog, there are various diseases that can be acquired. And one of them is hydrophobia. Hydrophobia means fearing of water. So Islamically, keeping a dog as a pet is wrong. Now, if you keep a dog and you believe it is wrong, that's a different question. You may not be a practicing Muslim. But someone to say you're not a Muslim, that's a very strong statement. Just because one person doesn't follow some portion of the Quran or some portion of the Hadith, as long as you believe there is one God and you believe Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God, as long as you don't do kufr, you cannot be called a non-Muslim, sister. As long as you agree, you have to agree what is mentioned by the Prophet, that keeping dog is prohibited because it leads to various diseases. Keeping a dog, you can keep him to guard your house, you can keep him to protect your cattle, no problem. But Islamically, keeping a dog is wrong. That's the reason a Prophet said that if the dog licks any vessel, you have to scrub it 3 times with earth. And today science says that even normally if you wash a vessel which the dog has licked, the germs are yet there. Only if you clean it with the earth does it go away. So imagine a dog comes into your house and he licks everywhere, he licks you and you are praying in that house. So but naturally it is filthy, sister. So Islamically to keep a dog as a pet in your house is prohibited, sister. Hope that answers the question.
Okay, thank you. But outside is okay, right?
Outside as dog for hunting, for protection, not as a pet.
For guarding the house.
Guarding the house, no problem. But not that you have to allow him to lick you.
Yeah.
Or to play over you.
If we pat them.
If you pat, you pat the head. Because the tongue cannot reach the head. So if you pat, you only pat the head. Because the tongue of the dog cannot reach the head.
Yes.
Hope that answers the question.